Hello. I would like to tell you a story. In the year 2000, Mexico didn't have an official poverty measurement. This means, actually, that the efforts in social policy were not guided by almost any indicator in terms of poverty. This means that when we talk about poverty reduction, we didn't know if we were winning the fight against poverty or if things remained the same. We didn't have a way to prove that the policies were right or not. Luckily, in the year 2003, we had our first poverty measurement in terms of income. That was the usual way of measuring poverty, using income. Unfortunately, we didn't have a big commitment in the country for that indicator to be the main indicator. Some people in the opposition believe that that was not the best way to measure poverty. Some people believe even that the government, the Mexican government, shouldn't be the one measuring poverty. Therefore, in 2005, there was a big agreement in Congress and between all political parties, and the federal government respected that agreement. This agreement meant that in Mexico, we should have an independent body to measure poverty, and also that poverty should be measured in a multidimensional way. What Congress said in practice, it was that to reduce poverty, to understand poverty, to measure poverty, we need to go beyond income. The law says poverty in Mexico should be measured including income, access to health services, access to education, access to social security, quality of housing, basic services in housing, and access to food. As we can see in chart one, what Congress was demanding was that poverty should be measured including income and including the main social rights. The Mexican Constitution is about rights, and therefore Congress wanted to have that same process in the poverty measurement. We needed to have income plus social rights. And this was a big political agreement. With that agreement, then we had the technical part of getting that indicator. Between 2006 and 2009, we engaged in a very rich academic discussion with international experts, with national experts, with government, with Congress, with the states, about finding the best way to measure poverty in a multidimensional way. By the end of 2009, we were able to have our very first multidimensional poverty measurement. In fact, Mexico was the first country to have officially a multidimensional poverty measurement. And we are proud of that. And then we started measuring poverty starting on the year 2008-09 onwards. Which were the uses of this indicator? Well, I believe that the first use of indicator was in terms of accountability. For the very first time, we started measuring poverty at a national, state, and municipality level. For the first time, the governors were accountable in terms of poverty, and also the municipalities were accountable in terms of poverty. This means that we had more policymakers engaged in trying to reduce poverty or being aware of poverty. So the very first use I believe, was in terms of accountability. Not only policymakers, but the general public, academics, journalists, the media, students were able to understand poverty, were able to track poverty in the country and in the states. And that's important. That use is very important. Having an indicator telling us if what we do in public policy is right, monitoring that element in a proper way, we believe is important. But then we have another use, a very important use in terms of public policy. Honestly, at the beginning, I believe the government were not aware of using that indicator to improve public policy or to use it for public policy purposes. But by the year 2013, the government and many governors of the states, and even Congress, were aware of the importance of reducing poverty using that precise indicator. And what is a very good element on multidimensional poverty? That many actions of public policy can reduce poverty right away. This is not the case with income poverty. For example, if you have a public effort to place children at a school, if you have public policy in which you improve the housing of poor people, if you have access to health services, when you measure poverty with income, that is not reflected on that indicator. We have to wait some time to improve income in the future. However, with multidimensional poverty, it is clearer that the efforts of government, the efforts of society can reduce poverty because you have many other tools to reduce poverty using a multidimensional poverty indicator. And this was used by the Mexican government and by many other governments locally in the states to have a stronger strategy to reduce poverty using this indicator. So what happened? Well, that many policymakers were aware that poverty had to do with education, with income, with health services, with housing, and with food. In this second chart, we can see very clearly that in the Mexican case, in order to reduce poverty, we need to improve both social policy and economic policy. We can see clearly that in order to reduce poverty and extreme poverty, we have to improve the way in which we reduce deprivations. This means we have to improve our social policy, but at the same time, we have to increase household incomes. We have to do much better in terms of income. This chart is showing us that the reduction of poverty has to do with economic performance and has to do with social policy. And I believe this type of charts made the government aware of the importance of using this device for public policy purposes. And therefore, we had a very important strategy in which, at least in the federal government and in some states, there were clear objectives of poverty reduction in almost every social ministry. So for instance, the Ministry of Education had the target to place children in school. If we have children in school between 3 years old and 18 years old, then poverty gets reduced on that dimension. If we have more health services and access to those services, then poverty has been reduced on that dimension. If we have better housing, which means that the quality of the floors, the ceilings, the walls is better, then poverty is reduced. Therefore, almost all ministries had their target in poverty reduction. And this means that the coordination of poverty reduction is clearer with a multidimensional poverty indicator. And that happened also in many states. And what happened between 2008 and 2018 is that extreme poverty was actually reduced. We can see that in chart number 3. Extreme poverty is reduced in part due to a better coordination using that indicator. It doesn't mean that we are winning the war against poverty. It doesn't mean that poverty is only about one indicator. It doesn't mean that social policy is only about poverty, but it means that using one indicator, using specifically a multidimensional poverty indicator, we can improve the coordination and the results of public policy. We still have so many things to do in terms of social policy. In Mexico, we still have so many things to do in terms of inequality. However, having a proper measurement, having a rigorous measurement, having a reliable measurement is, of course, a very important step to go. I really hope that when you can watch this video and other videos from other countries, we can learn much about the various ways of measuring poverty and the various ways with that instrument to reduce poverty quicker. Thank you very much.